Please go ahead, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Senator Grassley, the entire membership of the committee, thank you for the opportunity to testify today. As you put it, Mr. Chairman, this is nothing less than modern slavery that we are dealing with. The term trafficking in persons describes all of the conduct involved in reducing a person to or maintaining them in a state of compelled service, and estimates are up to 27 million men, women, and children victimized globally. Fortunately, there are hundreds of governments and NGOs who are committed to meeting this scourge. But as is often the case in places where poverty and corruption hinder the good intentions of committed people, a lack of resources and capacity are sometimes insurmountable roadblocks to those who seek to save victims from exploitation and bring their traffickers to justice. That's perhaps why, in the last 2 years, my office has received 998 applications for assistance from 546 organizations requesting a total of $547 million. Our foreign assistance budget for the last 2 years was $39.1 million, not even 10% of the demonstrated need. And we took a 24% pay cut, as it were, in the spring, down to under $17 million in program funds. We know that it'll never be possible to give every organization the help that they want, and we know that we have a responsibility to be responsible custodians of taxpayer dollars. And so we've implemented a rigorous and transparent review process to ensure that every cent of our foreign assistance appropriation is spent responsibly, is put to the use where it will do the most good, and has a multiplier effect far above the $17 million that we have to spend. We support grantees that are working to advance the 3P paradigm, prevention, protection, prosecution, that guides our effort to combat slavery here at home and around the world. These efforts are closely linked to the mandates and purposes that are laid out in the United Nations Trafficking Protocol, as well as the Trafficking Victims Protection Act and its subsequent reauthorizations, which, as you pointed out, Senator, enjoyed unprecedented and much appreciated bipartisan support throughout the years. The provisions of that authorizing legislation help to prioritize the allocation of the anti-trafficking funds from the appropriated State Department money. Because the 3Ps function as an interlocking paradigm, no single aspect stands alone. It's not enough to prosecute traffickers if we do not also provide assistance to the survivors and work to ensure that no one else is victimized. So we try to have projects that are cross-cutting in their approach, placing a particular emphasis on programs that involve victim protection, because we realize that it may be that the American program in a country is the only way that a trafficking victim will be helped. So 90% of the projects we funded last year, even if they have a strong prosecution element, also include a protection component, and 61% of them provide direct services to victims. Our foreign assistance priorities and our programming priorities are strategically linked to the tier rankings and diagnostic assessments included in the annual Trafficking in Persons Report. And my prepared testimony details specifically our grant application review process, as well as the steps that we take to monitor the use of funding after it's gone out the door. I ask that it be included in the record in its entirety. To summarize it, though, applications are solicited through an open process, thoroughly reviewed by my office, other State Department offices, USAID, interagency partners, and are sent to the Hill for congressional notification prior to the disbursement of funding. Following the awards, we monitor and evaluate the programs. We have officers who work to ensure project goals and objectives are implemented and funds are used responsibly. And program progress and financial reports throughout the project period are required, including final reports within 90 days of the end of the project. We take very seriously the responsibility attached to the use of these funds, but the real success is not the fact that we have an efficient program design and controls. The real success are the people. People like Shwega Mula. A few weeks ago, a CNN crew found her in the former home of one of Muammar Gaddafi's sons. She had become a trafficking victim when she left her home country of Ethiopia. She worked as a nanny for the Gaddafi grandchildren, and when she displeased the men and women for whom she worked, they poured boiling water on her head to punish her. She had no passport, no identification, no one who could help her. When the Gaddafi family fled the compound, she was left behind, three-month-old burns still open and seeping. Though we have no direct presence in Tripoli yet, the State Department was able to coordinate the effort through one of our grantees, the International Organization for Migration, to begin the process of getting Ms. Mulla out of Libya into a safe haven where she could begin the process of recovery. We hope that she'll soon be wheels up and under the care of both burn specialists and those who work with survivors of modern slavery. This is simply one high-profile incident and one example of how important it is to work on these cases, but she is merely one of 27 million, and we could never forget that. Because fighting slavery is more than good foreign policy, it's part of who we are as a nation. The last decade has seen renewed American leadership against slavery here at home and in our conduct around the world. The U.S. victim care regime is a global model for both restoration and rehabilitation of victims. The leadership is shown by our programs, our domestic activities, and our willingness to hold ourselves to the same standards by which we assess other countries, by including the United States in the annual Trafficking Persons Report. I thank you again for the opportunity to testify today, and we look forward to working with the committee further to provide information or answer questions that would provide additional clarity or background.